LLC called Fergus Limited. So I went to the building department. It's owned by a Samuel Arpell, who used to be married to Linda Matthews.
Matthews?
She was pregnant when he divorced her. She had a boy she named Justin. They shared joint custody, but he kept his mother's last name.
So the father put him up to setting that fire?
It looks that way.
You think you can coax him into coming in?
I could be very charming. You know that.
I have no doubt.
Bless the Lord, and these are gifts which we are about to receive from that by the minister.
Eddie, would you like any cornbread?
Yes, thank you.
Eddie? Welcome.
Thank you, Commissioner.
Frank.
Or Dad.
So do you cook?
Oh, me?
Yeah.
Yeah, but not like this. This is amazing.
Yeah, usually.
Just don't use your phone or iPad at the table.
More curse. They hate it when you curse.
I'm pretty sure she gets it already, guys.
Really looks great, Aaron. I love mashed potatoes.
Thanks. My mom's recipe.
Do you have any actual proof that Mom actually made these potatoes? You know, evidence.
What?
I'm just saying. Danny? Well, Dad, should we just take Aaron's word for it based on, a hunch?
My word on mashed potatoes does not need to hold up in court.
Whatever.
Well, from where I sit at this table, you can be accused of breaking rules that don't even exist.
If you're talking about what I think you're talking about, a rule can exist without being in a book.
But breaking an unwritten rule is pretty hard to prosecute now. Legally, yes.
But not practically.
All right, let's everybody just take a step back.
It gets like this sometimes.
Not always, but sometimes.
Most of the time.
Maybe you want to chime in too, Pop, about whether Eddie and I should ride together about breaking.